Thank you very much. I just wanted to come out before we start the show and welcome you and thank you for coming. This is going to be a very interesting show for me. This is the first time in 21 years I'm not on stage conducting everything. So it's kind of launch the ship and watch it sail. You know, it amazes me. I travel around the state a lot because I'm on a couple of boards for music groups, and it amazes me how much talent we have in our community. You're going to see that talent displayed tonight, and I think it rivals anything I've seen in London and New York and the Royal Grandy. You're going to hear very, very diverse things. You're going to laugh out loud. You're going to cry. You're going to be very moved in many ways. There's a lot of tremendous variety in the show. We did a show one time on tour, and after the show, and we were doing, this was a classical performance. After the show, they had a no-host bar and a reception for us. And all these people that had been in the concert were at the reception, and they talked to us quite a lot. It was quite a lot of fun. And at one point, I was standing at the food service, and this man walked up to me, and he said, "You know, you guys just have everything." I said, "Yeah, we really kind of pride ourselves in doing a lot of variety. We try to keep things interesting." And he says, "Yeah, you've got tall ones, you've got short ones, you've got fat ones, you've got skinny ones, you've got old ones, and you've got young ones." And I said, "Thank you." To this day, I still think that was the best response I could have done. Enjoy the show, and I'll see you at the end.
Right. But I will need a few things to put the story together. I'll need two bottles. Yes, very nice. They're children. One a boy, the other a girl. Next, a wall that the fathers have built to keep the children apart. And a tree the fathers planted to bring them back together. Later on, we'll add more parrots, some dancers and singers, and voila, you shall have your story. So won't you come with me? Follow. Try to remember the kind of September when life was slow and oh so mellow. Try to remember the kind of September when grass was green and grain was yellow. Try to remember the kind of September when you were tender and callow fellow. Try to remember and if you remember then
neighbor!
Friend!
How's your garden growing?
Growing well!
Mine too!
Ah, gardens, unlike children, so reliable!
So dependable! Plant a radish, get a radish, never any doubt. That's why I love vegetables, you know what you're about.
Maybe you'll get two. That's why I love vegetables. You know that they'll come through.
They're dependable.
They're befriendable.
They're the best pal a parent's ever known. While with children,
it's bewildering.
You
don't know until the seed is nearly grown.
Just what you've sown.
So
let the parent get the carrot,
not a Brussels sprout.
That's why I love vegetables, you know what you're about.
Life is very, if it's very vegetarian. A man who plants a garden is a very happy man. Plant a beanstalk, get a beanstalk just the same as Jack. If you can always take it back.
But if your issue doesn't kiss you, then I wish you luck. For once you've planted vegetables, you're absolutely stuck.
Every turn of green, every dignity, every plant grows according to the law. While the progeny,
it's hodgepodgeny.
For as soon as you think you know what kind you've got,
it's what they're not.
So plant a cabbage, get a cabbage, not a sauerkraut.
That's why I love vegetables, you know what you're about.
Life is very, can't be very vegetarian. A man who plants a garden is a very happy man. A vegetarian,
very, very
vegetarian.
What a good idea it was, how clever to build this wall.
Yes, and to pretend a few.
Imagine if they knew we wanted them when.
I'm sure they'd rather be dead.
Children.
Well, lovers.
How clever we are.
Crafty to know. To manipulate children, you merely say,
no.
there to be a happy ending.
Well, then I promise there will be. Look, my hand's trembling too.
Hear how the wind begins to whisper. See how the leaves go streaming by. Smell how the velvet rain is falling. Out where the leaves are warm and dry. Now is the time to run inside and say.
Oh, Whenever skies look gray to me, and trouble begins to brew, whenever the winter winds become too strong, I concentrate on you. When fortune cries, nay, nay, people declare you're through. Whenever the blues become my only song, I concentrate on you, on your smile so warm, so tender. When at first my kiss you decline, on the line in your eyes when you surrender, and once again our arms intertwine. And so it lies, men say to me, that love's young dream never comes true. To prove that even wise men can be wrong, I concentrate on you, on your smile so warm, so tender. The light in your eyes when you surrender, and once again our arms intertwine. And so it lies, men say to me, that love's young dream never comes true. Concentrate on you. I concentrate and concentrate on
while they're setting up, I'd like to tell you a story that was told to me by a Spanish-American woman in her 90s, and it was the inspiration for this song. We're in a New Mexico border town about the turn of the century, and a young señorita prepares to go to her very first dance. Her madre has made her a new dress, and her padre has bought her a new pair of shoes. They're very proud of her, and she's excited to be going to her very first dance and full of hopes and dreams. However, at the dance, the night goes by and no one asks her to dance. She does see one young senor staring at her all night, but she tries not to return the looks. And finally, the last dance comes around, and she starts to really despair because she hasn't had her dance. And Then out of the corner of her eye, she sees the young senor stand and come towards her, reaches out his hand, and without a word, asks her to dance. So she obliges, and they have their dance. At the end of the dance, the young senor steps back and bows, and still without a word, takes his leave. The next day, the young senorita is in her bedroom, and she's sort of daydreaming about the night before. She hears a knock at the door, and her padre gets up to answer the door. And a few minutes later, he comes into her bedroom, and he's got a quizzical look on his face. And he says, "I have a letter from a young gentleman, and he's asking for your hand in marriage. What do you say?" Without hesitating, she said, "Sí." So they were married, stayed so for 60 years until the young senor passed away.
Thank you.
ensemble, en tus brazos, señorita.
Thank you. My days are brighter than morning air. Evergreen pine and autumn blue. But all my days were twice as fair if I could share my days with you.
We're pausing for technical difficulties here. We'll be back on the air in one moment. Thank you.
Thank you.
that who is lost and lonely, be like was only. Not bitter, tragic joy I found in you. can almost taste hot dogs and french fries they sell.
promise.